I mix pretty much entirely on headphones. Given that on my home studio, I don't have access to good monitors or a properly conditioned room. This has some caveats, and even though I know my headphones pretty well, the mixes don't always translate to other systems. Recently, I discovered a simple method to calibrate headphones for a more truthful response, which works system-wide and can be implemented in pretty much any DAW and operating system. For example, I mostly use Bitwig on Linux and works like a charm there. No need for external plugins or other software like SonarWorks. The idea is to try to match your headphone's frequency response to the Harman curve, which seems to have become standard for audio mixing on headphones. This curve tends to match the preference of a multitude of people from different demographics. Instead of a totally flat response, it tries to mimic the response of flat speakers in a treated room and gives a closer approximation to what a studio environment sounds like. Ideally, you will be starting with a good pair of headphones, but you don't have to break the bank for the most expensive pair. There's massive diminishing returns here, and for $100, you can get something more than good enough for most people. I personally use a set of Beyerdynamics DT990 Pro, and while I like the sound and comfort, I had some issues with the build construction, so I wouldn't necessarily recommend them. Just find something that works for you within your price range, and try to keep them for as long as possible. To obtain the calibration curve, you can go to the Auto EQ website and type down your headphones model on the search bar. You will be greeted with a graph for which we only really care about the raw, target, and equalize plots. On the left, you can click Show Advanced and select different target profiles, or make any desired adjustments. But by default, the appropriate Harman curve should be selected. In the Select Equalizer app dropdown, you can select many options, including iTunes and Spotify. But for this tutorial, we will use the convolution EQ. You should be able to see the equalized graph very nicely matching the target curve. Click the download button and download the WAV file to your hard drive. In Bitwig or your DAW of choice, add a convolution loader in your master and load the equalizer file as an impulse response. Make sure that mix is set to 100%, wet gain set to 0, and width is set to 100. I like to add a tool device afterwards to gain match the before and after signal. You can group these two together and save the chain as a preset. But wait, we're not done yet. You could disable this chain if you're mastering or measuring your track, but instead, I like to create an FX bus and move the chain there. Disable your master output and set the input of the calibration channel to master, post. Don't forget to turn on monitoring. Lastly, set the output of the calibration track to your headphones output in your audio interface. You should now have headphone calibration directly on your DAW. Any air loader will work for this process. And if your DAW doesn't have one available, there are plenty of free VSTs for this purpose. You could potentially apply these equalization settings globally, but if you work with multiple headphones, this might become a hassle. Furthermore, in that case, you can just add as many FX tracks with their respective calibration IRs and route the audio as needed. I don't claim this is the best method for headphone calibration, but seems to work for me. And hopefully, it might work for you too. In any case, you should always listen to your mixes in a variety of different listening environments. Different headphones, earbuds, different speakers, your car, mono systems, etc. If this helps you out, please let me know. And if you have any more tips, write it down on the comments. Thank you, and until next time.